There's 1,000 problems. But the only problem that matters is number one, because if you don't solve number one, you never make it to number two. Hunt a Killer is an immersive experience. All of our members receive these packages episodically each month, and in these packages you've got things that come right from the crime scene for you to be able to investigate and immerse yourself into the story as a character. And you're really looking for who are the suspects and trying to identify means and motive. Hunt a Killer actually started out as an event, and you know, one thing that I've learned over my entrepreneurial journey is that entrepreneurship and business is really a series of iterations and pivots for you to be able to scale the business. And so basically we were able to find a product market fit for Hunt a Killer based upon an event that we put together. So we transformed this 200-acre campground into a living crime scene. And we had actors and we had staged crime scenes. And so coming out of that, we realized that we had found product market fit. But the biggest challenge that we had is just the money side of it. We could only support a certain capacity for the event. And that was really to keep that immersive factor. We really put our heads together at that point and tried to figure out what is a business model that can use the same concept, immersive storytelling, and how can we distribute that on a global scale? And so we actually pivoted the company after that to the subscription box. And the subscription box really enabled us to be able to distribute this experience across the world and really not lose any of that immersive factor. Last year we came in just under 100,000 subscribers, and we've been able to grow this business from zero to 30 million bucks in just a little over 3 years. And this year we're on track to do somewhere between 50 and 55 million. The biggest contributor to our growth has always been focused on product. Second to that would be the niches or the audiences that were already existing for this. When you think back to 2016, 2017, you had these communities created around these podcasts that were going from zero to millions of downloads, and they had these cult followings. And we were really able to tap into those communities, drive lookalike audiences off of different digital advertising means. And we were big into influencers and getting people that are actually going to enjoy this experience and be able to help them create content for their channels. I served 15 years on active duty and I'm still in the reserves. And there's a lot of different skill sets that have translated from military service to civilian. The military is all about redundancy. Right? So if this happens, then we've got 7 other things that we can do. For us, for instance, what if someone gets sick? What if the government shuts down our warehouse? We already had 1, maybe 2 53-foot trailers pulled up to the back of the warehouse, fully loaded with inventory to be able to take somewhere in the middle of the night once we got the word it had to shut down. If our warehouse would get shut down and we didn't have redundancies, we would have been out of business overnight. And so that's why it was so important to take the time and effort and invest into that. I think the other thing that translates from military to civilian or to entrepreneurship is resiliency. Entrepreneurship is very much a journey. And the only time you really fail is when you give up. And that's our whole kind of motto here. Like, we just won't give up. We will pivot the company. We will improve the company. We will find solutions. We will do anything it takes to win.